In a selfless effort to stop the spread of the coronavirus, Rabbi Green has established a collection center at Har Hashem where congregants can drop off Corona beer. Although the CDC has not yet established a direct link between Corona beer and the coronavirus, the rabbi is pretty sure that this isn't just some coincidence. Therefore, if any Har Hashem members presently have Corona beer at their homes or anticipate purchasing Corona beer in the near future, the rabbi would be happy to take the beer off your hands at no additional cost to you. So if you want to help him in this noble effort, you need only deliver your Corona beer to the trunk of the rabbi's car in the Har Hashem parking lot. From there, the rabbi will transport the beer to an undisclosed location where he will voluntarily quarantine himself with the beer until the crisis passes. As a cautionary note, depending upon the level of response from the congregation, the rabbi may not be in any shape to lead services next Friday night. So please check your email for possible schedule changes. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 2020 Har Hashem Purim Spiel. The cast and crew feel so honored that so many of you had nothing better to do this evening. On a personal note, tonight is my 25th Har Hashem Purim Spiel. And as with past Purim Spiels, I am just tickled pink to be here. Tonight's show takes a Broadway musical that is the backstory for a story that was never a Broadway play and combines it with a reality TV show that should never have been allowed to be a TV show and weaves a seamless web of incomprehensible entertainment that is sure to leave you asking, huh? But do not worry. I, as your loyal narrator, will do my very best to wade through the confusion and periodically bring the audience up to speed on what in the world is going on. But I don't want you to just rely on me. At crucial times, if you need to feel the free, if you feel the need, you feel free to nudge the person asleep in the chair next to you and ask him if he has any idea what's going on. Okay, with that said, or stumbly said, we should begin. As you know, Holly usually makes me start by saying that King Ahasuerus ruled over 180 provinces, and the king was mentally abusive toward his wife, Queen Vashti, and Vashti, after years of self-help therapy, finally liberated herself and from the abusive king, but then the abusive king, with the encouragement of his good old boy evil confidant Haman, cast his lecherous eyes in the direction of the lovely Esther, who was able, with the encouragement of her sometimes inappropriate uncle Mordecai, to use her wily feminine wares and a sense of feminine empowerment not typical for those times to influence the king to see the error in his previously anti-Semitic ways and to embrace the Jews and presumably Esther and cast out his former buddy Haman, leaving Haman in a world of hurt. But this year, the producers are shaking things up. We're starting the story at the end. Haman is already gone, which is somewhat confusing, but just wait. This is only the beginning. Well, it's really not the beginning, it's the end, but we're putting it at the beginning in order to eventually get to the end. Anyway, it's only going to get worse.
Thank you. is gone. The wickedest villain ever was. The enemy of all the future shot is gone. Good news. Good news.
Fellow Shushan, let us be glad. Let us be grateful. Let us rejoice if I the goodness could subdue. The wicked workings of
you. Isn't it nice to know the good will conquer evil? The true we are.
How did he come to be so wicked? How did we escape his wicked plot?
Who? Hey, oh, the man with the hat with three coronas, corners? Sure, I knew him, and I could tell you this story way better than that narrator guy, which is why they made me the executive director of Shusha's. But at this point, Brantz is really grandfathered into this job. And if I tried to preempt him, he would get really cranky because he's just an unbelievable diva.
Oh, how did we get along without you in past years?
I have a pretty good idea.
All right, let's go back to the beginning. King Ahasuerus, Fiero for short, rules over 180 provinces. He is spoiled, shallow, sexist, bigoted, but not yet the President of the United States. Settle down. I'm gonna say some stuff about the Democrats too. He even insists on being called wizard instead of king. Basically, Fiero's a putz. Meanwhile, the society over which he reigns is hopelessly divided. At his palace in Shushaz, native Shushazians, and hard to believe I've been doing this for all these years, isn't it? Enjoy the perks of privilege with parties going nonstop. The kind-hearted Queen Vashti knows things aren't right, but she can't bring herself to rock the boat. Meanwhile, the wizard's grand vizier, Haman, terrorizes minorities and foreigners in an effort to convince them to leave, especially the Jews, whom he despises. Haman has built a fanatical base by spreading the conspiracy theory that the Jewish God is using a wicked witch to control all the Shuzazians who should be on the stage by now and their institutions. Jews live in fear, but are careful not to protest too loudly. Where are you, Jews? Lest they be banished. There they are.
Divisions are, let us come together on this one day
and celebrate.
Oh, what a celebration we'll have today.
Thank goodness.
Let's have a celebration the worst way.
Thank goodness.
Finally, a day that's totally wicked, which free.
We couldn't be happier. Thank goodness.
Yes, we couldn't be happier, right, dear?
Couldn't be happier, right here. Look what we've got, a fairy tale plot, our very own happy ending. Well, we couldn't be happier.
True, dear?
Couldn't be happier. And we're happy to share our ending vicariously with all of you.
Press Secretary, I have striven to ensure that all of Oz knows the story of your romanticism. The day you were first summoned to an audience with Oz, and although he would not tell you why initially, when you bowed before his throne, Vashti the Good officially. Then with a jealous squeal, the witch it whispers from concealment where she had been lurking surreptitiously.
I hear she has an extra eye that always remains awake.
I hear she can shed her skin as easily as a snake.
I hear some Jews across the town are giving her food and shelter.
I hear her soul is so unclean, pure water can melt her.
What?
Melt her. Please, somebody go and melt her.
Do you hear that? Water will melt her? People are so empty-headed, they'll believe anything.
I know.
Believe it, okay? I know about these things.
Hey, hey, hey!
Hey, buddy!
It's my buddy!
It's my buddy! Yeah. Hey, King, it's time for your lesson.
Already,
Haman.
I'd rather go across the playground. Why?
To get to the other slide.
Ah, the other slide. Okay. About that, I got rid of the slides because people were having fun on them. Also, because some of the slides are water slides, and just so you know, I cannot get wet! Especially with water that looks kind of like confetti. Okay? Just remember that. That would be bad. I might melt, even. Anyway, running the kingdom is difficult, and we must at least pretend, hard as that may be, that you, instead of me, are the one who is doing it. So, let's get to it. What is the capital of Persia?
P.
King. Wiz, whatever you are this year. The witch is wicked smart, okay? Why don't you study like she did?
Well, what's her toughest subject?
Spelling. Spelling. Anyway. Yeah. Spelling.
You wrote it.
Spelling. Anyway, this is hopeless in more ways than one. You don't even know the difference between roast beef and pea soup.
All right, what is it?
Anybody can roast beef.
Look. Haman, I want to have some
hard
fun.
To believe they cut my lines.
It's important.
It's time to have some fun. Where's my queen, Vashti?
Oh, good idea.
Come on over, babe.
Hi, Liz.
How are ya? I feel like a skeleton at a party, though.
Why? Because you have no body to dance with?
How'd you know?
That's a dad joke.
Well, what do you mean by that?
The punchline is apparent. Look, Wiz, I know what's going on here, and I'm not going to perform for you and your disgusting friends.
Come on. After all, we were happy for 25 years.
Yeah, and then we met each other. I know what's coming.
What?
You don't want a partner. You want a trophy. And that sure isn't me.
Dance so
That was beautiful. It was beautiful. Bye-bye.
Once again, the king, a wizard, is a bachelor. Bachelor. That's a plot twist coming up. The wizard asks Haman, to help him find a new queen. Haman has heard good things about a young man named Chris Harrison, who has a novel idea for a contest to find the new queen. He'll find 30 women to compete for the wizard's love through a series of bizarre dates. After numerous eliminations, the wizard will pick the new queen by giving her a rose. Man, you can't make this stuff up. Now in the Jewish quarter of Shush Oz, live the righteous and pious Mordecai, who tonight is played by our very own Rabbi Fred Green. Give it up for the rabbi! And with him lived his niece. An unusually tanned young woman named Ethba. Go ahead.
Thank you. Esteba, I'm worried about your grades in Hebrew. They're like the Dead Sea.
Why is that, Uncle Morty?
They're below sea level. I can help you with your Hebrew. Just remember, who is he?
Who is he?
Precisely.
Precisely who?
No, precisely he. Me is who? That's me.
Oh, forget it. I'm gonna go play with my dog.
Fish.
Fish?
Dog is fish. Dog is from New York.
Oi. I'm sorry, Uncle, but I've been so worried about Haman.
No!
He's dangerous.
Don't worry, Esteba. Try to relax.
Relax? Now is not the time to be ignorant and apathetic.
What is the difference between ignorant and apathetic?
I don't know, and I don't care.
Haman. Oh, Haman, that's you.
Haman is always tweeting. He's always tweeting really mean things. Maybe I should tweet back at him.
I'm sorry, I don't follow you.
Esteba. Yeah, Esteba. Maybe you should enter the contest to be queen. It would help the Jews to have a friend in the palace.
But how would I fit in with all those royal snobs? They would never accept a nerd like me.
Oh, don't worry. God has sent a malach, an angel, to help you.
Seriously? An angel? Maybe I could just wing it.
Who wrote these anyway?
Not me.
Angel, malach, got it. Here she is. Here is your malach, Galinda.
It's Galinda with a G. Speaking of the Dead Sea, Mordecai is so old.
How old is he?
He's so old that when he was born, the Dead Sea was only sick.
I like that one.
It's not in there.
I know.
Esty, you are my new project.
Oh, you really don't have to do that.
I know, but that's what makes me such a menschy, Malak.
Whenever I see someone in need of Adonai, and let's face it, who isn't in need of Adonai? My tender heart tends start to bleed. And when someone needs a makeover, I simply have to take over. I know exactly what they need. And even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face, don't worry, I'm determined to succeed, to follow my lead. And yes, indeed, you will be popular. You're gonna be popular. I'll teach you to make some noise with the wizard's voice. Little ways to flirt and flounce. I show you what shoes to wear, how to fix your hair. Everything that really counts to be popular. I'll help you be popular. You'll hang with the right cohorts in the royal courts. Know the slang you've got to know. So let's start, cause we've got an awfully long way to go. Don't be offended by my frank analysis. Think of it as personality dialysis. Now that I've chosen to become a palimpsest or an advisor, there's nobody wiser. Not when it comes to popular. I know the popular. And with an assist from me to be who you'll be instead of really who you were or are, there's nothing that can stop you from becoming popular. Lar. La. Also, they were popular. Please, it's all about popular. It's not about aptitude. It's the way you're viewed. So it's very shrewd to be very, very popular, like me.
You know, that's stupid. Our prophets were popular now, but they weren't when they were alive. You're weird.
You're welcome. And though you protest your disinterest, I know clandestinely you're gonna grin and bear it. You found popularity.
Confidence in me, Glinda, but look at me. I'm Jewish. I'll never be popular enough to be queen.
It's Galinda. Now, come on, Esty. True, you're a little unusual. I mean, but that's not what matters. You've got brain, you've got heart, and somewhere in there I know you have courage. And as a wise old frog once said to me, it's not easy being green. We just need, oh, and I have an idea. We just need to put that quirky talent of yours to good use. Now listen.
Esteva, did you finish your essay for the Queen Contest?
Oh, not yet. I need a new thesaurus. Mine isn't just awful, it's awful.
Don't worry, that won't matter. You made a great video.
Oh, yes, you did. You did.
You think so?
Yeah, let's watch it all again.
Okay.
Describe yourself.
I'm a typical Persian girl who likes long walks in the desert and emptying chamber pots by the moonlight. I'm cisgender, a little green, and interested in men.
What are you looking for?
I like brown to blonde to reddish hair with a pulse. Wait, I mean silver. Yeah, silver's the best. And kind of thinning. Well, maybe more than thinning. Oy.
What would be your ideal date?
I would love to host a dinner party at the palace and unmask someone super evil.
What was your most recent date?
We went to a terrible restaurant. The food was awful, and such small portions.
Do you like to travel?
Yes, I love Switzerland. The flag is a big plus. I won't go to China, though, because that's a big red flag.
What else should we know about you?
I put the U in fun. Also, I can sing the entire preamble to the United States Constitution that will be ratified in 1776. We the people, in order to form a more perfect...
Beautiful, beautiful.
See, all those sessions with Galinda worked out.
A message from the great and wonderful wizard of Shushos. Let it be known to all Shoshonians, or Shushusians, or whatever you're called, that Esteba has been invited to the palace to compete in the finals of the rose ceremony! I have no idea what the rose ceremony is.
I don't have any idea what this show's about.
Hooray!
Hooray!
Oh, Miss Esteba, many years I have waited for a gift like yours to appear. Why, I predict the wizard could make you his queen this very year. My dear, now go at once to the wizard, join in his contest of dance. With a talent like yours, dear, there is a definite chance. If you work as you could, you'll be making good.
Did that really just happen? Have I actually understood this weird quirk that I tried to suppress or hide is a talent that could help me meet. If I make good, so I'll make good. When I meet the wizard, I will prove my worth. And then I'll show the wizard the greatest people on this earth. And with all his wizard wisdom, by my faith, he won't be blinded. Do you think the wizard is dumb? Or like Munchkin, so small-minded? No, he'll say to me, I see who you truly are, a girl on whom I can rely. And that's how we'll begin, the wizard and I. Once I'm with the wizard, all Jews' lives will change. 'Cause once you're with the wizard, no one thinks you're strange. No citizen's afraid of you. There's no fear of being named. And all of Oz has to love you when by the wizard you're acclaimed. And this gift or this curse, I have inside, maybe at last I'll know why. When we are hand in hand, the wizard and I. One day he'll say to me, Esteba, a girl who is so superior, shouldn't a girl who's so good inside show it on the exterior? And since folks here to an absurd degree
find you's well a mystery. Would it be all right by you if I demystify you? And since, of course, that's so important to me, all right, why not? I'll reply. Oh, what a pair we'll be, the wizard and I. Yes, what a pair we'll be, the wizard and I. Unlimited, my future is unlimited, and I've just had a vision, almost like a prophecy. I know, it sounds truly crazy, and true, the vision's hazy, but I swear someday there'll be a celebration in a dark that's all to do with me. And I'll stand there with the wizard, feeling things I've never felt. And though I'd never show it, I'd be so happy I could melt. And so it will be for the rest of my life, and I'll want nothing else till I die. Held in such high esteem, the wizard's new and favorite queen. It's half of Oz's favorite team. The wizard and I. Know how awesome we Jews are? He'll get rid of that evil Haman.
Careful, Esteban. Remember what the limestone said to the geologist.
What?
Don't take me for granite. I like that one. We have to be wary. Do not let anyone, especially Haman, know that you are Jewish.
Yeah. Also, he is such a thief. Do not tell him any puns.
Why not?
He takes everything literally.
Okay. But what is the wizard like anyway?
All right, let me get this straight. We've got this young woman with this complexion problem. And she's going to be one of the contestants in the Bachelor contest. We're doubling down on that, right, Paul? Okay. As I said, the wizard, Fierro, is shallow. As a teenager, he was kicked out of elite boarding schools, ended up in a military academy. His attendance at an elite college was the product of his parents' financial contributions and not his academic ability. And during his adulthood, his misogynistic behavior was reminiscent of an immature 15-year-old. Are we sure this guy didn't later go on to become president?
Of the congregation.
Ouch. Anyway, the contest continues.
Okay, ladies, it's time for the dance contest. Try to make the best of your time with the wizard, and remember to keep the reality in reality TV. Reality TV. That cracks me up every time. And now, the most musical episode of The Bachelor ever.
The trouble with schools is they always try to teach the wrong lessons. Believe me, I've been kicked out of enough of them to know. They want you to become less callow, less shallow. But I say, why invite stressing? Stop studying strife and learn to live. the unexamined life. Dancing through life, skimming the surface, gliding where turf is smooth. Life's more painless for the brainless. Why think too hard when it's so soothing? Dancing through life, no need to tough it when you can slough it off as I do. Nothing matters, but knowing nothing matters. It's just life, so keep dancing through. Dancing through life, swaying and sweeping, and always keeping cool. Life is fraughtless when you're thoughtless. Those who don't try never look foolish. Dancing through life, mindless and careless. Make sure you're wareless. Trouble is rife. Woes are fleeting. Blows are glancing when you're dancing through life. Take this cocktail party next.
How about the Azdust Ballroom?
Sounds perfect. Let's go down to the Azdust Ballroom. We'll meet there later tonight. We can dance till it lights. Find the prettiest girl. Give her a whirl. Right on down to the Azdust Ballroom. Come on, follow me. You'll be happy to be there.
Dancing through life, down at the altar.
If only because dust is what we come to. Nothing matters, but knowing nothing matters. It's just life. So keep dancing.
I'll be here all night.
Oh, that's so sweet.
But I know something that would be even sweeter. See this awesomely beautiful girl, the one with the hair. It seems so unfair she should go on a spree and not me. Gee, I know someone could be my hero if that someone were to go invite me.
I will invite you.
Oh, Wiz, really? You would do that for me?
Well, I would do anything for you, Wizard.
So
I'll be picking you up around 8.
After all.
Now that we've met one another,
it's clear we deserve each other.
You're perfect.
You're perfect, so we're perfect together. Born to be forever, dancing through life.
Oh, Esteban, isn't it wonderful?
Ladies.
Finally, for this one night, I'm about to have a fun night. And it's all because of ABC TV. And I only wish there were some way I could know for sure he will love me. Esteban, see, serve each other. And Chris Harrison helped it come true. We deserve each other, me and him. Please, Esteban, try to understand.
I do. Listen, Ness and I were just talking about you.
I thought you might want to wear this hat to the party tonight. It's really sharp, don't you think? You know, black is this year's pink. You deserve each other, this hat and you. You're both so smart, you deserve each other. So here, out of the goodness of my heart.
ladies, let's get it lined up. It's time to put the dance in this dance contest.
Bachelor gets to choose, but it's really the producers, which is really me, Chris Harrison. So Wizard, without further ado, it's time for you to go on your final one-on-one with Esteba, when you're ready.
Sorry, ladies. I'll see you later. Don't worry, though. I love our journey, and we're in a good place. And I am absolutely certain my wife is in this room. I think she's in about row 10. Love you, honey. Anyway, where were we? Oh, Esty. Oh my gosh, wasn't that an amazing date? I mean, bungee jumping out of an airplane, flying over the palace, totally rad.
I know. There is no better way to find true love.
I know.
Which reminds me,
yeah.
I've been meaning to tell you this. I've been working really hard to let my walls down and to tell you, I'm falling in love with you.
Esty, I feel the same. I mean, you're so different from the other girls. I just can't put my finger on it.
Family hour.
Music cue.
Kiss me too fiercely, hold me too tight. I need help believing you're with me tonight. My wildest dreamings could not foresee lying beside you, with you wanting me. Just for this moment, as long as you're mine, I've lost all resistance and crossed some borderline. And if it turns out it's over too fast, I'll make every last moment last, as long as you're mine.
Maybe I'm brainless, maybe I'm wise, but you've got me seeing through different eyes. Somehow I've fallen under your spell, and somehow I'm feeling it's up that I fell.
Every moment, as long as you're mine, I wake up my body and make up for lost time.
As a
pair. And though I don't care, just for this moment, as long as you're mine. for the first time, I feel wicked.
Wait.
Paul, your wife would like to speak to you in the hallway.
Wait.
I forgot one thing. Essie, will you accept this rose?
Of course.
Speaking of wicked, the king just made me Haman.
Donuts is a basketball team.
Yesterday, I told the Wiz that it was chilly outside, and he ran out with a spoon.
A spoon, yeah.
You know, the Wizard got airbags for his computer in case it crashed. And also, he thinks this homintoshin is pure protein.
All right, you made your point. Just think, not too long ago, I was just a talking head on the Wizard's favorite morning TV show.
You were on Locks and Friends?
Indeed I was. Life is wonderful. But you know what? To keep it that way, we're gonna have to make sure that we blame the Jews for everything that goes wrong.
The Jews robbed an Apple store yesterday.
How do you know?
I was an eyewitness.
So, in case you're wondering what a Grand Vizier is, what a wonderful Grand Vizier is, it's whatever I say it is.
What is?
It's a whatever I say it is.
A wonderful Grand Vizier anyway.
Whatever I say it is. Vizier rhymes with I don't know what.
So everybody knows.
Oh, the Jews robbed an Apple store yesterday.
We already did that. Let's just sing. I never asked for this or planned it in advance. I was merely blown here by the winds of chance. I never saw myself as a vile right-wing Socrates. I knew who I was, one of your dime a dozen mediocrities. Then suddenly I'm here, respected, worshipped even, just because equality was something some could not believe in. Does it surprise you I got hooked, and all too soon? What can I say? I got carried away, and not just by balloon. Wonderful. They called me wonderful, so I said wonderful, if you insist.
Your bass is wonderful,
'cause we say wonderful.
Believe me, it's hard to resist,
'cause it feels wonderful. They think I'm wonderful. Hey, look who's wonderful. It's such a kick. I said it might be key to build a town of green and a wonderful road of yellow brick. See, I want to banish the Jews, but to get the job, I had to convince the king I could fix the infrastructure. So, well there, where I come from, we believe all sorts of things that aren't true. We call them alternative facts.
Man is a traitor or liberator.
A rich man's a thief or a philanthropist.
Are foreigners honest traitors or ruthless invaders? It's all in which label you'd rather persist.
Now to push my bassities with my customary sleaze, I'll ban Jews and then they won't exist. Then call me wonderful, and I am wonderful, because for every ill it's Jews that I will blame, and in the end King will do the same.
At long last you achieve your due.
Don't you know the most celebrated are the really truly hated. There'll be such a whoop-de-doo, a celebration in Adar, when I banish every Jew. Wonderful, they'll call me wonderful.
It does sound wonderful.
Trust me, it's fun. When you are wonderful, it would be wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful. One, two, and... So, green, this year's pink, huh? All right. How's it going with the new queen?
I'm sorry, what?
How's it going with the new queen?
She's wonderful.
Oh, that's good. Just I got some administrative paperwork for you. We got to banish all the Jews because they're helping the wicked witch and spreading germs and disease and all that. So just sign right here.
You do what you need to do. Haman.
Ooh, yeah.
Hey, Esty, want to come over the rainbow with me?
Oh, I would love that, honey, but I need to speak with Haman first.
Later?
Yeah, see you later.
See you later.
All right, don't forget about me. We're good.
Looking for me?
Haman.
Greenie.
Why are you always telling such terrible lies about the Jews?
Alternative facts, my dear. And why do you care?
I'm not sure what your problem is, but I bet it's hard to pronounce.
Yeah, well, Esteblah, there's something kosher about you, and I don't like it. I'm gonna write my mom and dad a letter and tell them all about it. Dearest, darlingest, momsy, and possible.
My dear Morty.
There's been an intrusion on my plan to sway the winds.
But of course I'll muddle through it.
But of course I'll rise above it.
For I know you'd want I go the extra mile.
Yes.
There's been an intrusion, for you see my rival is.
And exceedingly peculiar and altogether quite impossible to describe.
Bile.
What is this feeling so sudden and new?
I felt the moment I laid eyes on you.
My pulse is rushing.
My head is reeling.
My face is flushing.
What is this feeling? Fervid as a flame. Does it have a name? Yes. Loathing, unadulterated loathing.
For your face.
Your voice.
Your clothing.
Let's just say, I loathe it all. Every little trait, however small, makes my very flesh begin to crawl. With simple utter loathing, there's a strange exhilaration in such total detestation. It's so pure, so strong.
is rushing.
Let's just say we love it all.
Oh, what is this feeling?
Every little trait, however small,
does it have a name?
She begins to cry.
Loathing.
Loathing.
There's a strange exhilaration.
Loathing.
In such total devastation.
Loathing.
It's so pure, so strong.
Quality groveling. Ready? Not yet. Go!
How shall I say this? No.
You got that, right?
I got it already.
Oh, that was the plan! So, right after the 13th of Adar and before the 15th of Adar, which happens to be the 14th of Adar, all the Jews will be banished!
Esteba and Galinda. Esteba, it doesn't look good.
Maybe we should get an ark. I know a guy.
That won't work. The joke won't work, and that won't work. You need to tell the wizard you are Jewish. I am a sentimental man who always longed to be a father. That's why I do the best I can to treat you, Esteba, as my own very daughter. But now Hashem will surely raise you high, 'cause God thinks everyone deserves the chance to lie. And helping you with your ascent allows me to feel so parental, for I am a sentimental.
It's a showstopper.
Hurt a little bit.
That won't be easy, Uncle Morty. Kind of like that note. It's really dangerous. Do you think I have what it takes?
Remember your book on defying gravity?
Sure. I couldn't put it down.
Exactly.
Okay. It's time to try. Something has changed within me. Something is not the same. I'm through with Haman, hurting Jews with hate and lies and blame. Too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes and leap. It's time to try defying gravity. I think I'll try defying gravity, and he can't pull me down.
Now I think you understand. It's
It's all part of God's master plan.
I'm through accepting limits, 'cause Haman says there's some things I may not change, but till I try, I'll never know. Too long we've been afraid of knowing that he wants us lost. Well, if he wins, it comes at much too high a cost. I'd sooner buy, defy in gravity. Kiss me goodbye, I'm defying gravity, and he can't pull me down.
Glinda, come with me. Think of what we could do together.
Unlimited. Together we're unlimited. Together we'll be the greatest team there's ever been. Glinda. Dreams the way we planned are.
If we work in tandem,
there's no fight we cannot win.
Just you and I, defying gravity. With you and I, defying gravity. He'll never bring us down.
Well, are you coming?
Hashem is with you now that you're doing this. I hope God brings you bliss. Now take my Bubby's broomstick and be Haman's nightmare Jew chick.
Jews will be happy in the end.
Now make it snappy, my friend.
Someone told me lately, everyone deserves a chance to fly. But I'm not flying solo. God's always there with me. To wicked Haman, take a message back from me. Tell him how I'm defying gravity. I'm flying high, defying gravity. And soon I'll send him out of town. And nobody in all of Oz, no Haman that there is or was, is ever gonna bring me
you can do with computer graphics. At times during a Purim spiel, the plot development requires a scene change, which requires what we professionals refer to as filling time. And the secret to filling time is to fill the time without the audience realizing that the time is in fact being filled. Some say filling time is so critical to producing an enjoyable Purim spiel that it's like the fruit filling in a Hamantaschen. In fact, some Talmudic scholars say that the first Hamantaschen had no filling, and it wasn't until the first narrator successfully filled time during a scene change in the very first Purim spiel that someone was inspired to put filling into a Hamantaschen. I'm just saying.
He's still talking.
And with that, the time has been filled, and I say, welcome to the royal cocktail party.
Hey, is Mushroom here?
I don't know. Why?
I'm excited for those of you who've never heard this joke before. He's a fun guy.
Hi.
Uncle, something's wrong. Don't look at me like that. Something is wrong.
Yes,
and
it is.
Don't eat the German sausage.
Why not?
I fear the worst. Oh, great wizard.
Why are you asking me about sausage?
You can't banish the Jews.
Why not, my love?
I have something I really need to tell you. It's hard. Because I'm a Jew.
What you are, Esteblah, is exactly like a broken pencil. Pointless. Hey. Adorable green monkeys, get out of here. Arrest the wizard. Yeah, I win this year. How do you like that big voice in the sky? Yeah, you got anything to say?
Disturbing plot twist.
No, not disturbing.
Oh my gosh, the flying monkeys have kidnapped the wizard.
Maybe we should send flying bagels to rescue him.
Bagels can fly?
Plain bagels can.
Esteban, plain.
Esteban, please pray for the wizard.
Okay, but you know, Hebrew is my worst subject.
You can do it.
Fiero! Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Let him quickly be free, light of day him regain. Though they jail him, let him feel no pain. Let his soul never break, and however they try to destroy him, save him, God on high, save him, God on high. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech what good is this chanting? I don't even know what I'm reading. Why in Hebrew school did I not even try? Fiero, where are you? Locked up needing freedom. One more disaster Jews can add to our generous supply. No good deed goes unpunished. No act of charity goes unresented.
Wait,
she's spiraling.
Stop her.
Trying.
Use my yand.
Stop, Esteban. Snap out of it. Sorry. What do you mean no good deeds goes unpunished? Jews don't believe in that. Remember our whole Tikkun Olam thing? Doing our part to heal the world. Even if we can't heal it all, we can't give up. We have to save the wizard and our people.
Thank you. You're right, Uncle Morty. But what can we do? How can we get past Haman's flying monkey guards?
I got an idea.
Of Adar, all Jews will soon be banished. And the mighty Haman is about to.
Welcome, everybody, to my little celebration. After we're done, there will be refreshments and water in the back. And you may recall, you don't want to spill water on me because why? No. I can't get wet! Especially not with green confetti like water. Okay? So, while you're back there, you'll be eating these triangular shaped pastries. And there's some fake news. There are some lies from the media that that's named after my hat. Is that stuff called Haman Hat? No. No, it's not called Haman Hat. It's called Haman Tushy. That's what you'll be eating.
Okay.
Haman Tushy.
Okay, yeah. Munchkins. Now.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah, that's what you need. Oh, no, it's flooded. It looks like confetti. I'm melting. I hate it when goodness wins and evil loses. It's so freaking Jewish.
Munchkins, now all Jews can be free and safe. Get him free and safe too.
Yeah, there's a history of violence. Really pushing the envelope this year.
But it's still stationary.
Any final words for us, Esteban? Please stop these jokes.
Respect our existence. Or expect our resistance.
And so, on the 14th day of Adar, came a day of celebration and joy. Here comes the poignant finale that always makes me cry.
I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return. And I know who I am today, because I know you. Like the eighth day after birth, when a moil blesses a son. Like a Yenta's marriage offer from a different who. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good.
God, I'm gonna cry.
Well, maybe that I will never meet again in this lifetime to mention. Play a bigger part in shaping me. I'm blessed by what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now at our Megillah story's end, it's time to celebrate freedom and also Hashem.
Like a Bobby's double cheek pinch on my sister and me. Like a rabbi's tashlik sermon in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? Because I knew you.
Because I knew you.
I have been changed.
And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame before.
But then I guess we know there's blame to share,
and none of it seems to matter anymore. Yenta's marriage offer from
do believe I have been changed for the better.
And because I knew you.
Because I knew you.
Because I.